If you don't want to miss out any of our uploads, all you have to do is just turn on the notification bell, and anytime we upload a new video, you're going to receive an alert on your phone from YouTube. Assalamu alaikum.
The prophecies of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam show that he was indeed a prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Secondly, the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam speaks of fitan. Fitan meaning trials, tribulations, calamities, one after the other. There will be confusion on earth. That is a prophecy of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, بادروا بالأعمال فتنا كقطع الليل المظلم يصبح الرجل مؤمنا ويمسي كافرا وَيُمْسِي مُؤْمِنًا وَيُصْبِحُ كَافِرًا. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, you need to overtake with your deeds the evil, the trials, the tribulations, the calamities that shall happen. They will be darker than the darkness of the night, the dark corners of the night, which means nobody will see right from left, nobody will understand what's going on, nobody will realize things. The only way to succeed at that time is to overtake these fitan, these calamities, these difficult times, this hostile environment by doing good deeds, al-a'mal. With good deeds, you will be able to overtake the fitan and the difficulties, the trials, tribulations of the age. Obviously, that is a hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, a person will be a mu'min, a believer in the morning, and he'll do something or say something or reject a verse of the Quran and so on. By the evening, he will be a non-Muslim. And in the evening, a person will be a mu'min, and by the morning, they will be a non-mu'min, meaning a non-believer. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not make us from amongst those. Then he says, in a hadith which is reported in At-Tabarani by Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam once made a dua. Powerful dua. He says, Allahumma barik lana fi sa'ina wa muddina. Oh Allah, grant us barakah in our measurements. Sa' is a measurement and a mudd is also a measurement. A sa' is slightly bigger than a mudd. A mudd is like a handful. So, oh Allah, give us barakah in our sustenance, in other words. And the next part of the dua, he says, wa barik lana fi shamina wa yamanina. And ya Allah, grant us barakah in the northern part of this region and in the southern part of this region. So that is what we call Palestine, Palestine and so on, Sham, Lebanon, Syria, those countries. And towards the south you find Yemen, and the term is used, Yamanina. Grant us barakah in this region. And you know that Islam has spread in the entire region. So one of the companions said, وَفِي عِرَاقِنَا. What about our Iraq, Ya Allah? Which means towards the east, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What about towards the east? Do you know what he said? Allahu Akbar. He says, إِنَّ بِهَا قَرْنُ الشَّيْطَانِ وَتَهَيُّجُ الْفِتَنِ. Allahu Akbar. In Iraq, there are the horns of the devil, and it is a place where the fitan will commence. Look at this. What a prophecy. This is reported in Tabarani years ago. There will be fitan in Iraq. There will be difficulty, calamity. That started at the time of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, and the others. And you and I know of the battles that took place in Kufa with the grandchildren of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his own daughter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. To this day, there is a lot of fitna there. What we learn from this is that it is a prophecy. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam already told us that towards that region of the east, there will be great difficulty. There will be a lot of fitan. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us. Another prophecy, another sign of Qiyamah, istidhafatul mali wa man'u sadaqah. There will be lots of wealth. People will become loaded. They will be so rich that nobody will take zakah. To the degree that when you go to people with your wealth and you tell them, this is zakah, we'd like you to take it, he'll say, no, I don't need this wealth. Allahu Akbar. We come to see that the weather patterns will also change according to the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You will have severe winters, severe summers. You will have lots of hurricanes, tornadoes. Look at what's going on as we are speaking in some countries of the world. May Allah protect us. You will have floods. You will have lots of rain, but no produce, no crop from that rain. You see, rain is such, the right amount will bring about the correct amount of crops. If you have too little, you have no crop. If you have too much, you also have no crop. Subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us, and may He not punish us with the rain. So much so that in another hadith he says, the Arabian Peninsula will become green and it will blossom again. Subhanallah. Today there are golf courses in the Middle East, and there are gardens that are more plush than those that myself and yourselves have. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us an understanding. These are prophecies of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he went to Tabuk, he told, it was Mu'adh ibn Jabal, if I'm not mistaken, radiallahu anhu, that, oh Mu'adh, if you are given age and you live long, you will see this entire place turning green where the well was. And subhanallah, to this day, in the middle of Tabuk, there is a huge green garden, and that's where the well was. Allahu Akbar. It's a prophecy of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then there is a hadith which says, by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِذَا ضُيِّعَتِ الْأَمَانَةُ فَانْتَظِرِ السَّاعَةِ. When trust has been lost, then wait for the hour. Which means, closer to the time, there'll be no more trustworthy people on the earth. Not at all. So, you look at people, they cheat you in business, they deceive you. You look at people, they rob you, they steal from you. You look at people, they appear so honest, yet they are not. They don't pay back their loans, enmity and so on, because of dishonesty. So this is also a sign of Qiyamah, to say people will lead countries and you ask them a question, they won't even know. Allahu Akbar. You see, today, if you take a look at the globe, the democracy of the world steers an ignorant person into the position of power because he is popular. Yet he doesn't know where Iraq is. Wallahi, I'm telling you. He doesn't know where Iraq is. And he leads the most powerful nation on the globe according to the masses. Allahu Akbar. Then there is another narration. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Yushiku an tada'a alaykum al-umam kama tada'a al-akalatu ala qas'atiha." Very soon all the nations will encircle you and they will come to attack you together, just like a pack of wolves come around a chunk of meat and they start ripping and tearing from it. So the nations will come and try and rip the Muslimin. We're witnessing it today. If you're a Muslim, by name also, you won't be allowed entry into some countries. Just because you have a name and an identity. That's it. What is your crime? Nothing. We probably have benefited humanity much more than the whole city put together. But they will say, no, you're not allowed. Why? Because you're a Muslim. Then there is another sign of the hour. We mentioned how adultery will increase, but shamelessness will also increase. People will be committing adultery on the streets. So much so that the hadith says the best man at the time will be the one who has the guts to say, listen, please can you go and commit this, whatever you're doing, behind the wall at least, not on the road. So he's not saying don't do it. He's telling them where to do it, because he's a little bit shameful. That's all. This is a sign of the hour. And this hadith, the Prophet ﷺ specifically mentions exactly, لَوْ وَرَيْتَهَا وَرَاءَ الْحَائِطِ. Why don't you go back behind the wall to do it instead of here in public? May Allah protect us. Wallahi, people are becoming shameless. Very, very shameless. Then there is a hadith, the Prophet ﷺ speaks of, لَا يُبَالِ الْمَرْءُ أَمِنَ الْحَلَالِ أَكَلَ أَمْ مِنَ الْحَرَامِ. A person will not be bothered whether they are eating from haram or halal. I'm not even bothered. So riba and interest will be eaten by everyone. And those who don't eat it, they will get the scent of it. They will be forced to deal in one way or another in such a way that they have smelt it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. We've arrived at that age. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam speaks about people who will have whips, whipping each other. Whips like the tails of the ox. The ulama have spoken a lot. The most interesting explanation I came across is by an alim of today's age who says there is some sexual misbehavior called BDSM. If you've come across it, they tie the partner or the spouse and they wear leather and they have these whips. They whip each other and so on. Prophesized by the Prophet ﷺ as a sign of Qiyamah. If you don't know about it, thank Allah. If you know about it, you still need to thank Allah that is a sign of Qiyamah and you've heard about it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us and grant us safety, and may He grant us all goodness. Remember, when we are intimate with our spouses, it's actually an act of worship. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us be human and be sane, and may He protect us from animal behavior and that which is unacceptable in the Sharia.